In this tutorial, Powerdirector 16, I'm going to teach you how to take the cinematic effect and make the black bars squeeze in and animate them. We're going to need a video. I'm going to drag that down. We are going to need a graphic that's a cinematic effect graphic, and I have a video on that already. I'll link it up and you can go check that out. And I'm going to drag that down here. And you'll notice now we have the black bars on top and on bottom. Now, up here in the top left of PowerDirector, we've got a disk and we've got a little blue arrow right here. We want to open that blue arrow and get into our color boards. That's going to give us the black box we're looking for. Now that we have our black box, we're going to drag one of them down and we're going to drag it pretty much on top of our cinematic image there so we can see how big we need it. We're going to double click it. And that's going to take us in here. Over here on the left side under Object Settings, we're going to turn off Maintain Aspect Ratio so that way we can resize that black box. Now we can actually grab it and resize it how we want. Now what we're trying to do is resize it to the proper width of this. And I'm even going to stretch it off the screen a little bit here. So now I've got the bottom one set up with that perfectly. I'm going to need another color board for the top. And we're going to do the same process with this one. Turn off our maintain aspect ratio. And we're going to start doing some stretching. Line it up. And I'm going to take that off the screen too. So now I've got my two bars and I'm ready to go. I'm going to move one in front of this graphic that has the bars on top and bottom. I'm going to move the other one underneath it. So now all we got to do is animate it. I think I'll start with the top one. If you don't see this box at the bottom, you see that arrow I got there? You can click and I can drag it up and down and make it bigger or smaller. This is going to allow me to put a keyframe in. Up here where it says position, ease in, ease out, there's a little triangle. That little triangle is where I want to drop a keyframe. But first, I want to take this and I want to move it kind of off the screen out of the way. Then I want to put my keyframe. And you'll notice down here, I've got a little red dot you can see there. Okay. Now I want to move this over to a certain position. And then I want to grab that box up here I had. And bring it back down and get it lined up. And you'll notice now I got a red there and I got a yellow there. I can go over here and click ease in. So now that's going to come in nice and slow. Now let me show you. See that? Beautiful. So let's go do the other one now. And it's going to be the same process, same thing. I'm going to take it and I'm going to pull it off the screen. I'm going to drop my keyframe in. Then I'm going to move it over. Just pick a place. So then we're going to drag it up and release. We're going to ease it in. We're going to say okay. So now I've got my black bar in front, my black bar on the bottom. I've got my cinematic image with my video. So now I can take this. Now we can start. You'll notice the box is here. Nothing's there. Hit play. See how they squeezed in? And there we have it, an animated cinematic view of when the bars squeeze in, and that gives you a cool look. Now you can do the reverse if you want at the end of the video where the bars actually go back out, and you could be like, oh wow. What do you think of this tutorial, guys? Don't forget to sub up, hit like if you like it, and I'll catch you on the next one.